Welcome back. AAC lesson number 4. You know the routine. Before we go on, a little review. A few more things about the three hoses, lines. Technically, a hose is made of rubber. Like this one, more than likely, is a suction hose because of the size, and there's rubber. Technically, a line is made of metal, in this case, aluminum. You see the AC lines are all metal. There is a little bit of difference. There's only 3. Okay, let's get them all. We've milked this one quite a bit. The beginning of the suction, the end of the suction, sweet spot number 1, sweet spot number 2. The suction hose is the largest of the 3. The opposite of the largest is the liquid line. We'll make sure you got a hint about the liquid line. Who knows what the last hose is? It's called the discharge hose. Look, there's only 3. Okay? Yeah, you got to know all 3 of them. Suction, liquid, and discharge. Right? And we see right here, the little pointer in the middle of the screen. Okay, this is the largest hose. This is the suction hose. And sure enough, this is the beginning of the suction. This is the end of the suction. Over here, the smallest line, I'm giving it away. That's the liquid line. Okay, the 3rd one is a little hard to see, but it's there. The 3rd one is a discharge hose coming from the compressor. If you're wondering what that is, that's called a muffler. We'll go over that later. If you can see that little pointer, that's the discharge hose. Okay, so there's 3 hoses. All right, new information. Okay, the 2 types of refrigeration systems. That's it. 2. Vehicles use 2 types of refrigeration systems, and yes, you have to be savvy about them. The 2 types are the tube type and the valve type. That's it, only 2. Expansion tube, orifice tube. We've gone over it a little bit, but if you remember, the expansion tube, orifice tube is where the magic happens. The magic of super cold, super fast. As the refrigerant passes through the restriction created by that brass tube, it changes pressure. And that's why it changes temperature. It changes pressure, it changes temperature. And yes, minus 57 degrees below 0. Expansion valves, 2 types. And they're both called expansion valves. This one on the left is a block type. We'll just call it the block type. And this other one, we can call it the 90 degree type. Okay? They're doing the same thing. They're changing pressure. They're changing temperature. The magic is happening at the expansion valve. Right? So we have a tube type and we have a valve type. All right, and you're going to have to know which one you got. And I'm asking you on the next slide, which one do you have and why? There's enough information on the screen for you to decide what you have. Don't try to look at the liquid line for that tiny little crimp. That's not how you're going to do it. The way you're going to do it is to look for this tank. Of course, this tank has a name. Okay, it's called an accumulator. The accumulator usually gives it away. This is an average looking accumulator, and it's on the suction. This is the beginning of the suction hose. I hope you can see that pointer. Okay, this is the accumulator. This is actually the evaporator. The evaporator is right here. This is a little bit older. Okay, the accumulator on the right should not be confused with the dryer on the left. I know they look the same. They didn't always look the same, but nowadays they kind of look the same. The accumulator is somewhere on the suction, somewhere, either at the beginning, the middle, or at the end. Here you can see that the accumulator is located at the beginning of the suction. That's an average good place to look for the accumulator. There's another accumulator. Do you see an accumulator on the screen? Okay, a good place to start looking for the accumulator is over here on the right, sitting in the vehicle, the nose left and right. This is the right side of the engine compartment, and this is a good place to start looking for the accumulator. But don't limit yourself. The opposite of the beginning is at the end. You can barely see it, but trust me, that red little tank at the bottom, close to the compressor, is the accumulator. The accumulator is somewhere, if you have it, somewhere on the suction. And you better know the suction. So what does the accumulator do? Well, it does several things. First, it tells you what you got.
If you have an accumulator, you have a tube, period. If you don't have an accumulator, did you figure it out? You're going to have the valve type, okay? Now we need to go ahead and introduce to the accumulator. We already know the compressor, right? It's like a little engine. We already know about the condenser. It's the radiator for the freon. We also know about the evaporator. The evaporator is like a large glass of ice water. The accumulator, let's get some more information. It's the drying element. It dries the refrigerant. It holds the moisture. Refrigeration systems cannot tolerate moisture. And they put in this desiccant, okay? Oh, pictures are good. Over here on the left, okay, is an accumulator. And I like the color. The blue means it's cold. The blue indicating cold. Over here is a dryer, okay? We're getting a little bit of information about dryers and accumulators. Okay, it also has a screen and filter. Why should you know that it has a screen and the filter? Because they're going to get plugged up. They're going to get plugged up on the guts of the compressor or the desiccant that's located in there. On the red one here, on the dryer, this red where the pointer is, that's the desiccant. The desiccant is the material that holds moisture. On the blue over here, the desiccant is not being represented. It'll have to be shown later. The two types of refrigeration systems are there. They look very close to the same. They both have compressors. They both have condensers. They both have the three lines, the suction, the discharge, and the liquid. They both have evaporators. But what's the difference? What's the difference? Well, let's start with this one. Because this tank device is located, I hope you're looking at the pointer. Because this tank device is located on the suction, that makes it an accumulator. And because we have an accumulator at the end of the liquid line, in this particular case, we have the orifice tube. Remember, the orifice tube can be located three different places. It can be at the end of the liquid line. It can be at the middle of the liquid line. And it can actually be, right there, it can actually be all the way at the beginning of the liquid line. Way over here at the beginning of the liquid line. Sometimes the tubes are there. Sometimes the tubes are kind of in the middle. Sometimes the tubes are at the end. This is a tube type refrigeration system. The next one, this is the valve type. How can I tell? Don't be looking for that little crimp and no, you're probably not going to see the valve. The easiest way to determine what you have is by looking for the drying element. Here, notice that the dryer, receiver dryer, is not on the suction. Now, the suction is this small little section right in here. This is where the suction hose is. This is the beginning of the suction. This is the end of the suction. This is sweet spot number two. This is sweet spot number two, number one. This is the discharge hose. Okay, this is the condenser. We have a dryer. We have the liquid line. At the end of the liquid line, we have a valve. Okay, the valves come in a couple different styles. The one on the left is a block type. And the one on the right, I guess they call it the 90 degree, right? And they're both out there. If it does not have an accumulator, and the accumulator has to be on the low side, suction, okay? That means that you have the valve type. There you have the compressor. Where's my pointer? There's the compressor. And yes, let me introduce to you blue and red. Blue means two things. Blue means low pressure, next week's next lesson. And blue means cold. Red means hot, and it also means high pressure. Let's go on. You can see the dryer, all right? How can you tell it's a valve type? Well, it doesn't have an accumulator. If it doesn't have an accumulator, it's the valve type. It uses a dryer. Dryers, where are they located? All right. In the beginning, dryers were located. Here's my little pointer. In the middle of the liquid line. Can we see the liquid line? Coming out of the condenser, and the arrows indicate the direction of refrigerant flow. The dryer is located in the middle. The liquid line would continue to hit that expansion valve. It goes into the evaporator. This is super cold, minus 57 degrees. It goes through the evaporator, follow the pointer, and then it returns to the compressor. Okay, dryers used to be located there. Dryers are you? Well, no telling where the dryer is. I'm headed somewhere with this, okay? The dryers used to be near the condenser. and they used to look like this, but boy, have they changed. All right, where's the dryer on this one? It's in the middle, the pointer. The dryer is in the middle of the liquid line. You see it? Okay, where's the dryer now? Well, it's over here on the left. Here's the dryer. You see the dryer? The dryer is very near the condenser. The condenser, again, looks like a radiator. It is a radiator for the refrigerator. It's called a condenser. It removes heat. I might have said it wrong at the beginning that it cools the Freon. No. It removes heat from the refrigerant as part of the process. Can you see the dryer now? It's over here, but they've come up with a new type of dryer. Oh, probably in the middle 2000s, 05, 06, plus or minus a bunch of years, they've gone to this replaceable dryer that is built into the condenser. I hope you see this little pointer on the left side. The condenser has a cavity, a cylinder, and in this cylinder goes the desiccant. Okay, at first, I didn't like it, but I've learned to like it a lot, right? These desiccant dryers are easy to replace. Usually, at the end of the condenser, on the side of the condenser, you have this fitting. You take the fitting off. Where is it? You take the fitting off, and the drying element comes out. Why should you be taking the element out? Because these guys need to be replaced. This is a very, very common component that needs to be replaced almost every single time, and you'll learn why. How can you tell if it's a dryer and accumulator? Oh, sometimes it looks the same, but the answer is location, location, location. Okay, high side, low side. That's going to be the next lesson. High side, low side. Accumulators are on the low side. The dryers are on the high side. Oops, that's a misprint up there. All right, and we have the end. Stop. End.